Hello and welcome to a WinRAR video. Today we are going to show you our top 5 tips for using WinRAR. Number 1. The first thing you can do when you open WinRAR for the first time is go to the Options menu right here above the toolbar. Select Folder Tree and then Show Disk Folders. Alternatively, you can use the shortcut Ctrl plus T. This makes it much easier to navigate your folders and files with WinRAR. This feature is simple, but also very helpful, and as it gets often overlooked, we wanted to show it to you as our first tip. Number 2. The toolbar. This one seems self-explanatory on the first view. But have you ever asked yourself what the infamous wizard button does? Well, wait no longer. We will give you a short overview of all the basic buttons in the WinRAR toolbar. Add. Press this button after selecting the files that you want to compress into an archive, and the dialog window for creating an archive will open. From here on, simply choose a name, your desired parameters, and click OK to create it. Extract to. This button is basically the opposite of the Add button. Select an archive and a window will open where you can choose which location your archive should be unpacked to, plus some other optional settings. You are also able to unpack multiple archives at once. Test. This button tests your archive for errors. All errors found during this test will be displayed in a diagnostic messages window. If no errors are detected, WinRAR will display a corresponding message. View. This button basically functions like a double click, and it opens the archive or folder or file in the internal viewer of WinRAR. Delete. This button is for deleting files, folders, archives, and such. In file management mode, it deletes the selected files and folders to the recycle bin, so you still have the chance to restore data that is accidentally deleted. But in archive management mode, the selected files and folders are deleted from the archive completely, without any possibility of restoring them later, so you need to be careful here. Find. Using the Find button, it is possible to search for files containing the specified keywords either in the opened archive, selected folders, or disks. Wizard. Now onto the infamous Wizard button. WinRAR's Wizard interface is designed for novice users and allows you to perform basic compression and decompression operations by following the simple step-by-step instructions. Info. In the file management mode, this button allows you to get the information about the contents of the selected files and folders. For example, the total size, the number of files and subfolders, or the number of archives. Repair. This button considers the selected files or opened archive as corrupt archives and attempts to repair them. Keep in mind that the success rate depends on the archive type and the type and size of the damaged area. The chances of successfully repairing a RAR archive are significantly higher if you have chosen to implement a recovery record when creating your archive. Also, it is not possible to repair archives with encrypted file names. Number 3. Let's talk SFX Archive. A so-called self-extracting archive is an archive that can be unpacked even if you or the person you are sending your archive to do not have WinRAR installed in your PC. If you're about to create an archive, you just have to click the option called Create SFX Archive. Your archive will be created as such, and you do not have to worry if the person you are sending your archive to is able to unpack it. Number 4. This one may be unconventional, but we still wanted to mention it since some of you may be wondering how to change the language of WinRAR. This step is easy but not obvious, since you choose the language of your WinRAR application when you download it. So if you want to change the language, all you have to do is to deinstall your current WinRAR version, go to www.win-rar.com and click on Download right here at the bottom. Now you can see an overview of all the languages that you can choose from. Feel free to pick any language that you might like and download it. Number 5. Tip number 5 is something for our users who bought WinRAR. We want to ensure that you can use WinRAR forever, basically, so make sure to back up your WinRAR key. This is the file that you download when you purchase your copy of WinRAR. Save it on an extra USB stick or hard drive and use it whenever you have to register WinRAR again, if, for example, you change your PC setup. Thank you for using our program, and I hope we could help you out today.